Hello, I am Moyos again, and today we'll see how good of a machine the TVS Apache RR310 is. So before you drool out to Nirvana, let me tell you something. This is by far the most beautiful thing I've seen on two wheels in the sub 500cc segment. Beefy fuel tank, smartly integrated body panels, edgy design lines, and aerodynamic front fairing with the brightest LEDs ever. It all adds up to make a spectacular looking motorcycle. I am pretty sure there are gonna be a set of people who'll buy this bike only for the weight looks.
The first thing you notice as soon as you're on this motorcycle is the seating position. I mean, from going by your looks, I expected the seating position to be too sharp, but for my surprise, it's comfortable. Like, it's somewhere in between the bricky KTM RC390 and the pleasant Yamaha R3. And it's so effortless to ride this motorcycle. The second thing I want to highlight about this motorcycle is the suspensions. I'll admit this, by far this is the most sorted out suspension I've ever ridden. And it's pleasant enough to take Indian bad roads, but also it can flip corners like a missile. I cannot help but, yeah, I'm in love with this suspension setup. So next up, let's talk about the engine. This is the same exact engine from BMW G310R. So as most European reviewers admit, this is not as good as the BMW standards, but it's still a lot of quality for an Indian manufacturer. So it's a 312.5cc DOHC liquid cooled fuel injected engine. And those are the exact words you want to hear in 21st century. Makes around 35 bhp and 28 Nm of torque on paper. But it's unbelievably fast.
As you pin the gas, there's a shit ton of vibration settling on your body. Probably the most YB300 I've ridden to date, making you feel like on a typical Apache. Well, I was informed by TVS that it is because the test ride bike was a pre-2018 production bike and a lot of people have been riding it very hard. Although I wasn't very happy with the response they gave me, hopefully the newer models are more refined than this. Because other than the vibrations, this is a sensational package.
The brakes. This is by far one of the best brakes I've experienced myself. Front brakes are extremely sharp and not at all intrusive. ABS works like a gem. But I can feel the rear lever actuating ABS. And that's okay because it works like a gem.
But I don't know how they messed up the gearing. The first three gears are on the taller side while the last three are short. Although that's a setup which is known to be most successful on the track, but for me, they expect taller final gearing which helps me cruise comfortably.
Okay, so let me throw you out a verdict. The Apache RR310 has one of the best balance between track racing and road riding. Makes good amount of power. Even in the cities. That's something I love on this motorcycle. It all sounds very good until you find out the price. 2.7 lakh on road. That's still something not affordable for most of us. And for around 20,000 rupees more, you have the frantic KTM 390.
So I have been riding this bike for some time now. There's something I want to point out. TVS did make an amazing motorcycle. Maybe it's just me, but I'd rather pay 20,000 rupees more and get a KTM 390 only for the extra power. Because the linear power delivery on the RR310 just doesn't excite me enough. And if you flip the tail and give me an option to choose between the RR310 and the Yamaha R3, I wouldn't be surprised to find myself on the Japanese. I know she's difficult to reach, she's not perfect, and there are a few flaws with her too, but the heart wants what it wants.